स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्द गुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं।
Here is again some personal question. Can I ask that? Energy darshan. Let's enter into the sutra. Devi enter etheric presence pervading far above and below your form. This is a Nitya Sutra. Means you are supposed to internalize and practice whole day, morning till night. Let me describe, explain exactly the word etheric. That is the key word here. Understand? You are not just the body as you think. It is only one part of you. Physical body made out of flesh and bones is one part of you. There is a second layer. The air which you inhale and exhale, understand? The prana which goes inside and comes out, that is the second layer, second part of your body. To kill somebody, you don't have to even poison the body. If you are just your body, if you are to be killed, your poison has to be added inside your body. But if poison is added, poisonous gas is added even in the room, the person will die. Means your boundary is not just the skin. You are not ending where your skin ends. The pranic layer is like a maybe, if you inhale and exhale deeply, from which distance you can smell, for example, you can smell, some people may be able to smell any smell which is there 6 feet distance. For some people they can smell even 20 feet. For some people, fortunately, you kept the nose very sharp. In the young age, if you are not suppressed, your nose will be very sharp. Your sense of smell will be very sharp. They can smell even 70, 80 feet. The distance you can smell is your pranic layer. That area, air, if it is polluted or corrupted, directly you will be affected. Then you may think, if my nose is too sharp, then I have to maintain too much area. Understand? Pollution, even if you don't maintain, it is going to affect the health. If your nose is sharp, at least you will know you are inhaling polluted air. You are inhaling polluted air, nothing else. The distance you can smell will be your pranic layer, prana sharira. Understand? In the physical layer, the distance between two persons is more. In the prana sharira, many of our prana shariras are overlapping, means the distance between two persons is less. That is why sometime when you sit next to somebody, you will feel uncomfortable. With somebody, you will feel very relaxed, very restful. In the meditation classes I have seen, before meditation, they will not feel any uncomfort to sit next to somebody. But after meditation, because the sensitivity has grown, they will just move out of that person. Move out of that person. Because now they can feel the pranic layer. Now the boundary is overlapping. Animals are very conscious and very intelligent about the pranic layer. You can see in the zoos, if the other animal enters the pranic layer, that's enough. This girl, he'll be showing the face. And early morning, if you see Indian streets, I've seen the dogs will go around and ensure their pranic layer is protected by pissing in the light bulbs. And they'll go around and ensure that their pranic layer is, their boundaries are protected. Anybody who enters inside the boundary itself is enough. This fellow will get ready for fight. Without moving away, when you close your eyes, is mental layer. For example, if you close your eyes and able to visualize this hall in one single frame of mind, in one single visualization, if you are able to visualize this hall, this is the distance of your mental layer. For example, if you have to visualize the parking lot, you may have to leave this frame and go there. You may have to unclutch from this frame and visualize the parking lot. Kids can visualize at least 10 times more space than you. That is why many questions they ask, you are not able to answer. Understand? If you are in an open space, if you are in front of an ocean or a vast hilly region, how much area you can visualize? You may be able to visualize some 30 degree vision. This much area only you will be able to visualize in one picture in your heart, in your inner space. If you have to visualize the other side, you have to move this out only as a second thought or as a second visualization only you can visualize. But with the kids, they can easily visualize 120 degree. 120 degree. And especially the child, kids who doesn't go to school, who are not abused by the so-called verbal-based, word-based education system, logic-based education system. Of course, I can't say it's a Western, because now Eastern, Western, everywhere, logic-based education system. The kids who are not abused, abused by the logic-based education system, they will have 360-degree visualization. Understand? When I talk about my first experience, I talk about this only. I was able to visualize, I opened up to the visualization of 360-degree. Kids, till you finish them making like you, till you give birth to your software into them, when you give birth only to hardware, your hardware in them. Only genetically they are affected. When you put your education system in them, you affected them mentally also. You affected them mentally too. Till they are affected mentally, till they are abused by the, I wanted to use this word again and again, by the logic-based education, which is the worst damage done to the human mind. When the logic-based education system is given, they lose the ability of visualization, seeing things under one visualization. The creativity or innovation is lost. I tell you, along with the verbal, word-based or the logic-based education, if your kids can do little meditation or this carving, anything directly done by using the hand, carving or painting or completely involving eyes and the hands, they can bring the visualization energy back, efficiency back to their system. If that can be done, it will really take care without abusing the kids. Anyhow, mental layer means the area you are able to visualize without any need to move away. For example, if you are visualizing now, able to visualize now this whole hall, one more important thing. Most of you may not even be able to visualize this whole hall at a time. Once you, even the whole hall, if you see, you will see first people, then you will see the screen. Even for this hall, you may need 2-3 movement. The area which you are able to visualize without moving is the mental layer boundary. Mental layer boundary. One more important thing. Like if Annamaya Kosha has to be killed, poisoning Annamaya Kosha is needed. Through Pranamaya corruption, poisoning the polluting the air is needed. In the mental layer, anybody who is inside that mental layer, his ideas will go into your system without your editing. That's an important thing. So corrupting ideas are put in your head. That is why whatever ad goes on in the television enters your head. Because that time, that becomes your mental layer. That becomes part of your mental layer. Hardly 10% you logically analyze the news which is read out to you in the TV or the informations which are told to you through the TV. Because in the TV, in 10 minutes, almost you become part of that mental layer. That becomes part of your mental layer. That is why 90% of the words and ideas which is told to you through the TV, just goes inside. Corrupting 2-3 TV channels is enough to pollute the whole mental setup of particular country, certain country. Fourth layer, very important. Etheric layer. Understand? Mahadeva talks about the fourth layer here. Means layer of emotions, sentiments. Here the boundary will be bigger. Here the boundary will be even between USA to India. If your relatives are there in India, the distance is too much. Even if they are there, if they are sick, the suffering will be there for you. If somebody dies, the suffering will be there for you. The etheric layer is too big. Understand? Physical layer is only 6 feet. Your skin is the boundary. Pranic layer is the area up to the area you can smell is the pranic layer, boundary. Mental layer is the area you are able to visualize in one frame, one visualization. That is mental layer. Etheric layer is based on emotional connection. It does not have boundary. Does not have boundary. It is only based on the love or emotional connection you have with people. The feeling you have with people. The connection you have with people. An important thing you need to understand about the feeling or the connection you carry with the people. Even unconsciously it affects you. Even if you don't know they are sick, suddenly you will be low. Why you don't know? Then you will get the telephone call, they are sick. When you are really connected, even without logic, without knowingly, even if you are not informed to your conscious mind, your unconscious will start suffering. Mahadeva says, start feeling the etheric presence. Understand? When you start feeling the etheric presence of you, means where all your energy is invested, all your emotional connections are like your energy investments. You can easily unclutch yourself from the sufferings. If you can find out all the etheric presence connections, your etheric layer connections, you can easily unclutch and enter into the enlightenment or the energy place, energy plane, where there is no bondage, where there is no disturbance. If food poison happens, your annam, the physical plane, can be corrupted. If the air pollution happens, your pranamaya kosha can be disturbed. If a thought pollution happens, your manomaya kosha can be disturbed. If emotional ideology pollution happens, your etheric layer can be disturbed. Understand? Somebody can be tortured or prisoned. Here you will be suffering without even you directly getting involved with it. You can be tortured through remote control way. That is what is etheric layer is all about. Many times, I have seen people feel etherically connected, means emotionally connected. Maybe the word etheric is too mysterious or mystical. If you are emotionally connected to the people who are back in your home, or if you are emotionally connected to people, some group of some religion, some group or some language, whenever some problem comes for them, you are here suffering. I have seen people suffer for no reason. I am all for serving lovingly and compassionately. If a tsunami hits, serve compassionately, nothing wrong. But don't start suffering. People think only by suffering you can serve. No, if you are suffering, you will not have energy to serve. You will not have energy to serve. Stop suffering. Have empathy. Empathy means feeling they are suffering and immediately working to remove it. Sympathy means suffering along with them. Empathy means working to remove their suffering. You are not supposed to suffer with them. I have seen. If Tamilians suffer there, here the Tamilians feel suffering. If the Hindus suffer there, here Hindus feel suffering. Somewhere if Muslims are suffering, here the Muslims will suffer. If you have etheric connection, emotional bondage, you invite, you accept, you are waiting for more and more suffering. Mahadeva says, feel your etheric presence with whom all you feel connected. Just for 10 days, try this technique. Feel you are present to all the people with whom you are feelingly connected. You are emotionally connected. Feel like a light beam in the form of a big light. You are connected to all the people with whom you emotionally feel connected. For example, if your parents are there in India, and if mostly none of you feel connected emotionally, if at all you feel emotionally connected, just visualize continuously. Your body is huge enough to accommodate the whole India inside, and they are there inside you. It may look very funny, but in 10 days, you will have so many new revelation. Understand? So many new revelation. How you imbibe, bring, invite new unnecessary sufferings. When you feel connected to them, even if they are not suffering, if they are going through some incident which you think is suffering, you will create suffering for you. Many times, they will be completely free, relaxed, resting. But what you think is suffering, if they go through, what you will do? You will feel the suffering and you will create suffering for them by forcing it on them. No, 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 this cannot happen to you. We do same thing in the name of love. I call that as a loving torture. Now I go through many times from disciples. Especially when they feed, they think if I eat more, they will get more punya. Based on my weight, they will get more punya. I don't know then what will happen to me. See, the suffering which we invite unnecessarily, unconsciously, the moment it is brought to your conscious awareness, it will disappear. Not only with parents and relatives I am talking. Many ways you may be connected to your religious people, or your community people, your group of people, or your language people. You will have the common identity connections. Understand? Conditioning is one of the dangerous things. If you are connected to the whole world, that is wonderful, you will never bring suffering for yourself. Because when you expand to the whole world without boundary, there is no ideology based connection. That does not belong to etheric, that belongs to cosmic body. Etheric body means emotion based connection, conditioning based connection. Conditioning based love, conditioning based connection will always lead to calamity, will always lead to danger, will always lead to violence, because the other part, the part which you excluded, naturally you will be violent towards them. Naturally you will be violent, angry towards them. I have seen how the conditioning brings so much of suffering unconsciously to a person, and the suffering which he enjoys or cherishes adds, creates more violence and suffering. Understand? Ego means working based on pain body and expanding the boundary of pain body is ego. If you are making some decisions because of the people whom you think is your own is suffering, all your decisions to alleviate their suffering will add only more suffering to the planet Earth. You may add suffering to somebody else, and that person naturally will add suffering to the group which you are thinking as your own. See, I for I will only end up making the whole world blind. You will remove his eye and he will remove, as a revenge, one person from your party. And all you guys will remove now one person from their party. If continuously this goes on, where it will end? It will make the whole world blind, that's all. Ending place will be whole world blind. Mahadeva says, enter etheric presence, pervading far above. Understand? He knows, I think. People are going to live too far and have the etheric connection. That's why he says, he does not say above, far above. And far below your form. Your form may be the center, but with whoever you feel connected emotionally, if some particular language people, or a religious people, or a relative, or community, anything condition-based connection. Condition-based connection. 10 days, from morning till night, be aware of all of them as a part of your own body. Visualize you have a huge light body. Body of them are inside you as part. Maybe looking very funny, feeling very funny, you may think, how this can lead me to enlightenment? You do not know. You do not know with how many conditionings you are suffering in unconscious level. Only when you practice this, you will realize all the layers and layers of conditionings with which you are suffering unconsciously. They will all come up to consciousness. The moment they come up to the consciousness, naturally you will be unclutched from them. You will be relieved from them. You will be relaxed from them. Understand? The sutra is very powerful. May not directly now, you may not feel, how can this open enlightenment? Till you open the door, you will not be aware what is inside the building. I have seen so many people. When they come inside our temple, when they open the Vedic temple door, it's hardly 7 feet door. They never imagine anything. They can't imagine what is inside. The moment they open the door inside and second door and look inside, God, huh? They get the shock, because psychologically you always feel inside you will see things only up based on the height of the entrance. If the entrance is 7 feet, inside also you already imagine or come to a pre-conclusion, prejudice, you are going to see only the things which are taller, equivalent to the sight. You never imagine, only when you see, suddenly you have the shock, God, what is this? How did it all come inside? How all these deities are there? The moment only when they see inside, they get the shock. That is why I just wanted to agree, really wanted to name that place as a shock spot. The moment they open the eyes, oh God, it's such a shock. Till you see, you do not know what you are going to see with that key. Same way, till you practice for 10 days, you do not know how many layers of your own conditioning you are going to experience with this technique. You will see two big things, much more than what you expected. It is a very wonderful technique. The next sutra is a continuity. Actually, it is a same sutra. Only one small difference, technique, the difference in technique. Put mind stuff in such inexpressible fineness, above, below, and in your heart. Understand? The same technique. In first technique, Mahadeva says, experience the etheric presence above and below you. In the second technique, he says, it's actually a developed version. After you practice the first, you have to do second. You can't do second directly. He says, be aware of all the etheric connections you have. Means the etheric bodies, boundaries you have. Along with that, be aware of your boundary also. Here you need to put awareness in two places. Let me describe exactly what Mahadeva means. In the first sutra, he says, just put your awareness on mind, that is enough, I will automatically get dismantled. Because I has no individual base except the mind. The second he says, sometime you would have collected a very strong eye, you don't even know the corruption, the depth of corruption which exists in that eye. Beyond conditioning, you may be having some ideas. So put your awareness on that also. Understand? Two different techniques. Maybe the second technique for real thick heads. Real thick heads. First technique is remember, be aware, expand to all the psychological, emotional, etheric connections which brings you suffering. I have seen many times. See, if you can stop accumulating etheric anger and etheric lust, that is enough, you are liberated. Because the anger or lust which you can contain in this body will never be harmful to you. Will never be harmful to you. I have seen people carrying the anger which directly is not involved to their life. If somebody is killed somewhere who is supposed to be the community in which he is born and brought up, here his blood will boil. When they read the news, let him suffer. I know he should have it. Sitting in front of TV, they will be shouting. Accumulating the anger more than what you need to run your day-to-day life is the danger. Accumulating the lust more than what you need to run your day-to-day life. Some celebrity is dancing in the TV. And already you accumulated the lust, which you can't directly use in your day-to-day life, which is useless. In your day-to-day life, that lust is not going to be useful. But you accumulated that lust. Naturally, that is going to stay inside you as a blockage. If you have the lust with the person with whom you are living, which you can directly express, means useful to your day-to-day life. Useful to your day-to-day life. Accumulate lust or anger useful to your day-to-day life, that will never be dangerous. That will never be dangerous. I tell you, it will only help you to run your day-to-day life with excitement. Somebody goes to a doctor and says, doctor, I want to live 100 years. What all should I do? Doctor asks, do you drink? He said, no. Do you smoke? No. Do you fool around, date around? He says, no, I live a straight, simple, pure life. Then doctor asks, then why do you want to live 100 years? Understand? I'm not saying disconnect or destroy everything, accumulate the anger which is needed only for your day-to-day life. You may need anger to run your business. You may need little shouting to maintain your office discipline. You may need little lust to have the excitement in your relationship. You may need little lust to keep the love or to keep the family going on. Have the lust, have the anger, have the emotions which are directly needed for your day-to-day life. Not etheric. Seeing some particular dimensioned male or female who are called models jumping somewhere, if you accumulate the lust which is not going to be directly straight away useful in your day-to-day life, you are creating blockages. You are creating disturbance in your etheric system. Understand? Be aware of even all those attachments. If you have your hero, if you are a fan of somebody, 15 days remember that person is part of your etheric body. Because all those things are also directly connected with whoever you are attached. Remember all those things as part of your body for 15 days. Suddenly you will see how much of suffering is added into your life by them. Not directly by them. Your emotional attachment to them. Your attachment to them. Same way, whoever you don't like, for no reason, you don't like somebody. Alright, you don't like, that is true. Your hatred, can it do anything to that person directly? No. It is not directly going to be useful in your day-to-day life. I have seen people sitting with the newspaper and reading the mortuary columns and feeling, this fellow, he needs this. As if you are never going to die. As if your photo is never going to appear in that mortuary column. Maybe it may not appear in that column in the newspaper, but it's not that you are not going to die. At least somebody has given an advertisement for him in the mortuary column. I've seen. Means vengeance which is not directly useful in the day-to-day life. Lust which is not directly useful in your day-to-day life. If you can accumulate the anger, lust, all the emotions which is directly needed for your everyday life and spend it, your life will be like the barber before finding the golden jar. It will be contented, fulfilled, wonderful. But the moment you find the golden jar and try to fulfill it, like collecting the anger and collecting the lust, collecting the violence which is not directly useful in your day-to-day life, which you can't spend. The big problem with that yaksha's jar, golden pot, is you will never feel like taking it out and spending. You will only feel like filling it. Same way, the collected anger and lust which is not directly useful in your life, you will never be able to spend it. You will be only accumulating it. And anybody who is working based on the accumulated anger and lust without reason, without the direct use, will continue to suffer, because all their decisions will be made on the pseudo anger, pseudo lust, which is not directly useful in their life. Be aware, two techniques, understand? Be aware, first 10 days, only about the etheric body. That itself will take your awareness. You will not be aware of you also. Just be aware of all the etheric connections and the body around the world, all your likes and dislikes, love and hatred, all the connections. Remember, everything is inside you as part of your body. Move with the same visualization for 10 days. You will see so many understandings and revelations and great spiritual clicks happening in you. So many initiations will open up. Second thing, second part, if in the first part itself, if you achieve the truth, then no need for second. Otherwise, the second part, be aware of you also, center also. Then, so many other things can happen. Put mind stuff in such inexpressible fineness above, below, and in your heart. That's the only word added. The key word added is, and in your heart. That is the essence. Understand? Both techniques are today, fortunately, part of the same sutra. Because I am seeing many of you are tired after attending two long days of workshop. So, I think Shiva knows maybe. After the 2-day workshop, the sutra is going to be taken. So he gave both the techniques in one sutra so that you don't have to sit for more time. I'll tell the essence in few lines. Visualize all the love, hatred, emotional relationships which you have in your life as part of your etheric body, means light body. Visualize you have a huge light body. If you have somebody who is really emotionally connected to you in India, visualize you have a huge body which extends up to India, and that person is inside that body. 10 days carry this visualization. Let all the emotional hatred or loving connections be inside your etheric body. And if you experience the ultimate click with this technique, go ahead with this. If not, the second thing, add, along with that, be aware of your center also. Your center also. Then you will see the new layers of click opening up. So, let you, of course, tomorrow we have the last day of Shiva Sutra. So, welcome you all to be here tomorrow to enjoy the last day of Shiva Sutra here, because I'll be doing the remaining few sutras in the ashram, Indian ashram, I'll complete it. So, formally, the public lecture Shiva Sutra will be ending tomorrow. It took almost 2 years. I remember 2006 January we started, and 2007 December. It took 2 years to comment on at least around 100 sutras. We'll be finishing the public discourses on Shiva Sutras tomorrow. I welcome you all. So let these sutras be internalized by you and practiced by you. Let you all achieve and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.